Revlon, love is on.
Closed captioning is provided by...
People who have been diagnosed with mesothelioma have many questions. That's why we offer this free book. Call 1-800-400-4416.
My husband had stopped for an animal in the road. A truck came along and did not stop.
Elaine turned to us to help fight for the care and money her husband deserved.
Kogan and DeSavo, they're all wonderful people. They work very hard. They never quit. They don't give up. If there's any other avenues that they can explore, they'll do it to help you as much as they can. We've been very fortunate to have them.
If you or a loved one has been seriously injured, call Kogan and DeSalvo now.
Me? You got me?
MeTV is memorable entertainment television.
Sure sounds good.
With a lineup of classic television shows you remember.
I remember years later.
And shows you can discover for the very first time.
What a good stuff.
You can watch MeTV South Florida over the air on 5.2 and Comcast 216.
Are you going to watch me or ain't you?
MeTV is memorable entertainment television.
Hooray for me!
It's the annual BrandsMart USA huge 4th of July sale. Get these countertop appliances for only $19.88 each. How about a Samsung 32-inch LED TV priced at just $178.88? Get this swivel screen portable DVD player for only $34.88. Or take home this GE top load laundry pair for just $799.76. Hurry in. It's the annual BrandsMart USA huge 4th of July sale.
They make little hearts happy and big hearts happy too, because as part of a heart healthy diet, those delicious oats and Cheerios can help naturally lower cholesterol. Cheerios. How can something so little help you do something so big?
Arizona, it's time for pop quiz. Here's your question, okay?
Ready.
Who won the Ultimate Icon Award last night on the BET Awards? Was it Janet Jackson, Smokey Robinson, or Sean Puffy Combs?
Janet Jackson.
Yes! Congratulations, Margarita! We are sending you back to Arizona with a $100 gift card to Burlington!
You feel for Olive Garden's fresh baked breadsticks? Well, multiply that by a million. They're here. New breadstick sandwiches starting at just $6.99. Only at Olive Garden.
We're seeing storms on Live Viper 5 Max. Steve will have your forecast at 5 and a local woman's warning after she almost didn't get a big insurance check. Today on WPTV News Channel 5 at 5.
The Zero Down Summer Celebration at JM Lexus. Zero Down delivers on new Lexus vehicles. RX 350, only $479 a month. Zero Down. Visit jmlexus.com.
Car accident?
People are talking about Steinger is going green.
They sure are. Get this.
After Marita's accident, they got her $94,000.
I like the sound of that.
Then you'll love this. They got Eric $392,000 after his accident.
Check this out. Steinger is going green got Rod $900,000.
$900,000? Talk about getting paid.
If you've been injured in a car accident, find out why people are talking about Steinger is going green.
800-561-1111.
I got a lot of love, people. My heart is pounding with flavor.
Craving big-time flavor? Get Checkers and Rally's famous Big Buford. Add our Big Chicken Deluxe and get two of the same or one of each. Just $5. Checkers and Rally's.
It's in the bag.
Hey, Ralph, do you go north for the summer?
No way. Molly, I wouldn't miss Two Treasures at Crystal Tree's Super Summer Sale.
The savings are really hot.
Holly loves it, too.
True Treasures at North Lake sizzles with new selections of furniture, artwork, and accessories arriving every day
all for vacation.
True Treasures, of course. There's no better value or fun for my budget.
I guess I'll never have this place to myself.
You will have fun shopping at True Treasures.
Right now, during the Zero Down Summer Celebration, drive your choice of new JM Lexus vehicles with Zero Down. Like a new IS250, only $379 a month. Zero Down.
When you think Lexus, think JM Lexus.
I want to thank my guest today and my co-host, my fantastic one-of-a-kind studio audience tomorrow. You know we've got you covered with all the latest hot topics. I love you for watching today, and I'll see you next time on Wendy. Bye-bye.
The Now South Florida, stories everyone's talking about right now.
Making sure you're in the know.
With new information before everyone else.
It's a bold new way to get your news. The Now South Florida, weekdays at 4 on WPTV News Channel 5.
It's really traumatic, and especially at my age, just to be in a car accident, it is horrifying. It really is. When you're in a car accident, you're not a whole person anymore, and Gordon and Donna made me whole. As an educator, we communicate. And with Gordon and Donna, they did educate me and let me know exactly what was going to happen all through the process. They pieced my life back together, and it was the best decision, really, that I've made.
Gordon and Donna, for the injured.
Nissan gave a lucky few the ride of their life in the 2015 Nissan Altima.
Where am I going? Where am I going?
Nissan Altima. With blind spot warning and up to 270 horsepower. Get the ride of your life at your local Nissan store. Choose the 38 mpg Highway Altima and get up to $1,000 bonus cash. Bonus cash ends June 30th. Shop ChooseNissan.com. Nissan, innovation that excites.
Watch the Honda Sports Desk for the latest local and national sports, powered by ESPN 106.3. Every night at 11, only on News Channel 5. Sponsored by the South Florida Honda Dealers. Visit sfhondadealers.com to find the dealer nearest you. Catch your News Channel 5 updates throughout the day on News Radio WJNO.
Good afternoon. We begin with breaking news right now. St. Lucie County Fire Rescue on the scene over down power lines at Southeast Lingate Drive in Southeast Vets Memorial Parkway. Firefighters also dealing with a possible lightning strike on Southwest Barbosa Avenue right here. Two palm trees on fire there. Here are the storms causing this entire mess. A strong line of storms making their way across the Treasure Coast. Let's get right now to Storm Team 5 Chief Meteorologist Steve Weigel, who's tracking this mess for us. A busy start to our Monday.
I would say so, yeah. The wild weather on the Treasure Coast is starting to improve, but it's moving into Palm Beach County. So Palm Beach County, through the afternoon and early evening, you're going to get some of this crazy weather, too. So keep an eye to the sky. Keep it right here. We'll keep you up to date. That storm, those line of storms, are actually around the lake now, and they're moving toward the coast very quickly. We have had reports of over 55-mile-an-hour winds on the Treasure Coast. From that, there's that earlier line that pulled through Port St. Lucie, as Ashley told you. Some damage from that, some very strong winds as it moved through Port St. Lucie, Jensen Beach, and Fort Pierce. Now just rain working through. Pockets of rainfall, a few lightning strikes. The heaviest storms, though, are off the coast now, so it is improving in a big, big way. Also, some rainfall into Jensen Beach. The earlier storms have now pushed off Hutchinson Island. So it's just kind of persistent rain through the early evening hours on the Treasure Coast. Palm Beach County, temperatures are sky high, 90 or above, 98 right now, 97, 98 popping up around Wellington. And here's our rain. It's moving into Belgrade, Pahokee, South Bay, Port Mayaca, and Indiantown. And this packs a punch. Lots of lightning strikes, torrential downpours, and this is moving toward the coast. You'll also notice this right here. That's our afternoon sea breeze. Once they come together, watch out. We're going to see these collide around 20 miles. mile bend and then work toward the east. So we are looking at a pretty active day across Palm Beach County. It's already starting, as I said, in Belgrade. We're looking at winds around 50 to 55 miles an hour, just near visibility in these downpours. Lots of lightning here, strong gusty winds. It's all moving east at about 20 miles an hour. So pulling through, as I said, or pulling into Belgrade, all the way off across the eastern side of the lake, headed toward Jupiter and all the way down into Boca. Times of arrival appear to be anywhere from about, 4:30 through about 6:30 tonight. So a busy afternoon and early evening. We'll keep you up to date right here.
All right, Steve, thank you. Right now, an Okeechobee mom locked up after deputies say she's been smoking pot with her 11-year-old for over 6 months. Brian Enton is live at the Okeechobee County Jail, where he is learning more about how this was all uncovered. Brian?
Ashley, deputies say this entire investigation started at the 11-year-old's elementary school. That is where they say he told an assistant principal that he smoked pot with his mom. Casey Sanders behind bars after her 11-year-old son told Okeechobee County Sheriff's deputies smoking pot with his mom, quote, made him sneeze. Police reports say he's been smoking pot with his mom since January in this pink trailer, smoking out of a wood pipe shaped like a man's body part, according to reports.
I was mad. I wanted to fight her. You just don't smoke with a child that young. That's just not cool.
Tracy Evans is the 11-year-old's former guardian. She says she is relieved that Sanders is still locked up on a $13,500 bond. The Department of Children and Families is not commenting on the case, but according to the sheriff's office reports, they are involved, and right now they have custody of that 11-year-old. In Okeechobee, I'm Brian Enton for the Now South Florida.
Right now, police in Greenacres still searching for a motive for why a grandmother would want to kill her daughter and two grandchildren. Police say after Nilda Sheffield shot Elizabeth Flores and her two children, 7-year-old Xavier and 2-year-old Sophia, she shot herself. The family was found inside their home on Saturday. Investigators are now talking to friends and family to try to find a motive here. The man accused of killing a St. Lucie County deputy is in court today, Aris Tisdale. He's scheduled to go on trial in September. In court today, his lawyers are arguing that some statements Tisdale made should be thrown out because the prosecutor didn't identify himself before talking to Tisdale. The prosecution showed video of Tisdale's interview after his arrest. They also called the lead detective on the case, who said Tisdale received his rights and agreed to speak without a lawyer.
Did you approach the defendant with the understanding or belief that he wanted to speak with you?
Yes, I did.
And in fact, did he agree to speak with you?
Yes, he did.
Another motion the judge will look at during this two-day hearing has to do with whether law enforcement will be able to wear uniforms in court during the trial and where they will be allowed to sit. The trial set to start September 15th. A woman was rescued this morning after being trapped in a culvert. The rescue happened just before noon in Lake Mary in Palm Beach Gardens. These are exclusive pictures from Chopper 5 right here. Police say the 32-year-old was swimming in that lake and some people heard her yelling, so they called fire rescue officers who were able to pull her out and get her to the hospital. Funeral arrangements have been announced for the St. Lucie County detention deputy killed in a car crash last week. Visitation for Deputy Sheriff Alan Ross will be held tomorrow at Westside Baptist Church in Fort Pierce. The calling begins at 5 and the funeral will take place Wednesday at the church at 1:30. Ross was driving into work last Thursday night on I-95 when he crashed his car. Prison escapee and convicted murderer David Sweat has been upgraded to serious condition under heavy guard in an Albany hospital. He is also speaking to authorities about his time on the run. CNN is reporting Sweat told authorities that he and Richard Matt planned to go to Mexico with prison worker Joyce Mitchell. But when Mitchell didn't show up as planned earlier this month, Sweat and Matt had to improvise. Sweat also told investigators that he left Matt 5 days ago because Matt was slowing him down. When Sweat was caught on Sunday, he had a backpack of supplies like maps, tools, and bug repellent. Matt was found and killed on Friday near Malone, New York. Summer vacation is off to a pretty bumpy start for a West Palm Beach family after encountering what they call terrible customer service with Spirit Airlines. The Now's Katie Johnson introduces us to a local dad who may never let his son fly alone again after what happened, Katie.
Well, George Bays booked a one-way ticket to Houston for his 12-year-old son, Noah, and paid extra for a chaperone to make sure that he gets there safely. Noah's aunt would pick him up in Houston on Saturday night. That was a plan, but bad weather sent the flight to Dallas. And George says crew members on board never notified the family. This dad says it wasn't the airline. Instead, it was a call from his son to let him know that something was wrong. The airline's fix for this problem: send Noah and the rest of the passengers on an unchaperoned Greyhound bus to Houston from Dallas. When George found out that was the plan, he was furious. His son Noah instead stayed in the airport waiting hours for his aunt to pick him up.
When the plane leaves, it's out of your control, you know, so you're relying on someone else to take over your parenting skills as a chaperone, and that just didn't happen in this case.
Now, Spirit Airlines allows kids between the ages of 5 and 14 to fly with the aid of an airline chaperone. An airline spokesperson says they're looking into this incident. Ashley.
All right, want to bring you up to date. We have a severe thunderstorm warning now for western Palm Beach County until 5 o'clock because of this line of storms that's moving through the area. Winds approaching 60 miles an hour are possible. Very, very heavy rainfall and lots of lightning, hundreds of lightning strikes as this storm, line of storms move through the Treasure Coast. We also have reports of damage around Port St. Lucie, and this is really firing up quickly across Belleglade, Pahokee, South Bay, all the way up into Port Mayaca, headed in toward Indiantown, then eventually toward the coastline between about 5 and 6:30 tonight. Everything's moving east at about 20 miles an hour. A concern here, very strong winds, and as I said, winds approaching 60 miles an hour are possible. The real core of this storm is over the lake, but it is moving into Pahokee, into South Bay, into Port Mayaca, and into Belleglade in the next 10 to 15 minutes. So it's already bumpy with lots of lightning, but more on the way. In fact, heavier rainfall in this area. Beginning to improve now across the Treasure Coast with just light rain there. But this line, as I said, is heading through Palm Beach County. There's the polygon. Just popped up there in the last couple of minutes for western Palm Beach County, where that storm warning continues until 5 o'clock. Keep it right here. We'll keep you up to date on any severe weather that pops up.
Steve, thanks. Coming up on the Now, launch failure. What's next for the astronauts on the International Space Station after their supplies explode? Then, should Florida officials help you save for retirement? How some states are making sure you have enough to live on when you stop working. And an incredible story of survival, lost in a forest and giving birth, one woman's determination to keep her and her newborn alive.
When it's 5 o'clock on News Channel 5, you need to know what's happening right now. Local coverage everywhere.
The only local reporter in Baltimore.
Steve Wingle with weather safety and accuracy right when and where you need it.
Off Boynton Beach in Delray.
The only local chopper getting you breaking news first.
Broke into several cars and then fired.
Now that's local coverage you can count on. WPTV News Channel 5.
You've been in an accident. And now you have a choice. You can call Rubenstein Law at 1-800-FL-LEGAL. Just last year, we recovered over $75 million for our clients. The choice is yours. Rubenstein Law.
Call 1-800-FL-LEGAL.
Texting and driving can get you killed. The attorneys of Cersei Denny, taking time to care.
This is history in the making. Cortez, 23 years old. First woman in the majors.
Never miss a moment. Get live TV on the go included with AT&T UVerse TV for just $19 a month for 2 years with qualifying bundles and 1 year term.
If you need to make a workers' compensation claim, call Gordon and Donner at 333-3333 or visit fortheinjured.com.
At the Indian River Press Journal, we cover local. With the largest news gathering operation in Indian River County. Stories affecting your life right now. And those shaping your future for tomorrow. The environment. Education. Crime and politics. Indian River County is growing, and so is the Indian River Press Journal. And TC Palm Social and the Press Journal is your guide to fun in and around Indian River County. Things to do, things to see, things to try. At the Press Journal and tcpalm.com, we cover your backyard every day. Where you live, where you work and play. The Press Journal and TC Palm, online and on time.
Enjoy your new shield.
Thanks. How much did you spend on this?
Nothing. It was free, and they put it in just a day.
Well, if it was free and they put it in that fast, how good could it be?
You tell me.
She's got a Sloman Shield, the ultimate home security system. It's free, and yes, it's real good.
Okay, the system's great, honey. Please disarm it.
Welcome back. Severe thunderstorm warning continues for western Palm Beach County until 5 o'clock tonight. This area rain here and thunderstorms moving into Belleglade, Pahokee, South Bay, all the way up into Port Mayaca. And the rainfall is actually developing right across into Jupiter now. This line that cuts across Jupiter Farms, Jupiter, and back into Belleglade. Our warned area is right over Belleglade and South Bay. These storms are moving east at 20 miles an hour. Gusty winds to 60 miles an hour, lots of lightning, dangerous lightning, and the potential here for some damaging winds. We'll keep you up to date through the afternoon and let you know if we get any more warnings in.
All right, as NASA continues to investigate why a rocket carrying supplies to the International Space Station exploded after takeoff, the astronauts in orbit are now facing a difficult reality. The rocket was bringing them food, science experiments, and computers, about 4,000 pounds in supplies, actually. And it's the third unmanned cargo mission to the space station that's failed recently. NASA insists the space station crew has plenty of food and water to last until the fall. And a warning today about the debris from the rocket. If you see some, don't pick it up. The Air Force says it could be potentially hazardous. If you do see debris in the water or see it washed up anywhere along the shore, call police immediately because all of that debris is considered part of an official investigation. With the world's financial stability in limbo, millions of Americans are paying more attention to their own savings. And when it comes to retirement, most of us aren't saving like we should be. And McNamara explains how some states are stepping in to help.
78 million Americans do not have 401k plans through their employers, meaning they're saving very little or nothing at all.
Retirement 65? I don't think so, unless I hit the lottery, and that's not going to happen.
They should save more. I save money. My friend over there saved money, and we're glad we saved money.
So now 17 states considering setting up state-run IRA programs. Take Illinois, for example. This month, a new law requires any business that employs 25 people for 2 years to offer a retirement savings plan. California now looking into a similar option. But a handful of states reject the idea. For example, Indiana and Colorado both failed to get bills through the legislature. The problem, red tape and paperwork to get businesses on board.
We as an industry, if we want to be cost effective and be able to kind of solve this coverage problem, we would definitely prefer it to be a federal issue. So we have one set of rules and one set of regulations to follow instead of having to figure it out 50 times over.
Another negative, state-run IRAs have much lower yearly contribution limits. $5,500 if you're under 50 and $6,500 if you're over 50. Compare that to 401k limits, $18,000 if you're under 50 or $24,000 if you're over 50.
But I think they look at the demographics that aren't saving and they kind of think that this is probably a good enough place to start.
It might encourage people to save more, which is always a good thing.
For the now, I'm Ann McNamara.
Greece teetering right now on the brink of default. And for people there, it means the most they can withdraw from an ATM is about $67. Talk about restrictive, right? Well, the government imposing that limit and closing all banks. Trading in Greek stocks and bonds has also been halted. The country has until tomorrow to make a loan replacement of about $2 billion. Some iPhone users on T-Mobile's network are suffering from the dreaded blue screen of death. You know what I'm talking about? It's pretty awful. Well, according to posts that have been piling up on social media, the screen on some iPhones on T-Mobile's network flashed blue right before rebooting without warning. It's pretty annoying. The restarts occur at 10 to 30 minute intervals and appear to affect the iPhone 6, 6 Plus, and 5S. Some users say you can solve the problem by turning off Wi-Fi calling. Other people saying they just had to do a complete hard reset. Challenges on social media have become a trend in recent years. Remember the ALS challenge? That's a great one, but others, not so great. A current one that's causing some concern right now in the medical community is the belly button challenge. Renee Tessman explains.
It has gone viral on the Chinese version of Twitter, and now the belly button challenge is making its way to the United States.
The premise is if you can reach behind your back and reach your belly button, that you are healthy or fit.
It has Heather Gallivan, clinical director of the Melrose Center, which treats eating disorders, very concerned.
Healthy bodies come in every shape and size, and really being able to reach around your body to touch your belly button is more a function of your arm length and your shoulder flexibility than an indicator of health.
She's alerting parents because kids know what's happening on social media more than parents do. And this kind of social media pressure, she says, can lead to eating disorders.
Unfortunately, these challenges really kind of perpetuate a lot of body shaming and that only one size is okay when in fact that's not true.
So she says, talk to your kids about the belly button challenge. Tell them it is not an indicator of health.
That we're more than what our body is, and really focusing on the things our body allows us to do regardless of shape or size.
Value true talents and not what long arms and flexible shoulders allow you to do.
Okay, this is a pretty incredible story here. It's a story of survival, really, for a pregnant Nevada woman. She gave birth by herself while lost for days in a national forest. Unbelievable. Amber Pangborn was trying to get to her parents' home when she began having contractions, but she ran out of gas and was out of cell service. So early in the morning, Amber gave birth to her daughter all by herself. She had very little water and only 4 apples to survive on. And after a couple of days, Amber was able to start a fire that caught the attention of rescuers.
And I was just crying, like I was just so happy because I thought we were going to die. Like I was just so glad that like someone finally seen us and like we were going to be okay.
Well, Amber and baby Marissa were taken to the hospital this past Saturday. A day later, Marissa was flown to another hospital for further evaluation. Okay, switching gears now into weather. We have some major storms to talk about that are making their way across the Treasure Coast.
Yes, actually through the Treasure Coast now. It's just rain on the Treasure Coast, but very strong storms in Palm Beach County that are going to have an impact through about 6 o'clock tonight or 6:30, Ashley. And lots of lightning, severe thunderstorm warning now for Belleglade and South Bay. Gusty winds to 60 miles an hour possible. We've already had reports of some winds approaching that. And this is the polygon here for the severe thunderstorm warning. These are moving east at 20 miles an hour. This line is now extending to the coastline. And look at what's happening in Jupiter to Cuesta, Palm Beach Gardens and the farms. A big area of rain here. Torrential downpours. Also, South County, Boca del Rey. Also, more showers and storms firing up very quickly. So we're going to get this forming. We have this moving into the west. It's going to be a wet afternoon and early evening. And if you're doing any travel, try to stay inside until these storms pass. If you encounter any kind of severe weather, just stay inside. They're going to linger into the early evening hours, and then we'll see an improvement after that. We're already seeing a big improvement on the Treasure Coast tapering off now. More storms possible tomorrow. We'll talk more about that in the next hour and a half.
All right, Steve, we'll see you then. Thanks. A waitress wasn't expecting a lot from tips, but things quickly changed. The life-changing gift she received from a group of strangers. You got to see it. Plus, it'll cost you more to travel the Florida Turnpike. How much extra cash you'll need to get around South Florida.
Enjoy a wonderful yacht cruise on the picturesque Intercoastal aboard the beautiful Lady Atlantic or Lady Del Rey. Pass stately mansions while enjoying a cool drink or delicious food prepared right on board. This summer, it gets even better with friendly rates. Find us at DelrayYachtCruises.com.
You're right. Time for new tires. With your appointment, we'll install them in less than 59 minutes, or you get $59 back and a free oil change.
Sounds good.
The 59-minute quick tire install. Guaranteed every day with an appointment. You can even time us. That's another plus from Tires Plus.
Hey, guys. Happy Monday. Another perfect sunny day. Now that's Monday morning coffee. The best. Monday morning status meeting. Let's do the wave.
Now the beginning of the week could take on a whole new meaning. Play the Week for Life family of games from the Florida Lottery and you can win up to $5,000 per week for life. Plus, with a payday second chance, you can win one of various cash prizes. Florida Lottery, just imagine.
When bad weather hits, trust Storm Team 5 for complete weather coverage where you live. Storm Shield, alerting you to severe weather when you want to know before, during, and after the storm. Storm Team 5 Weather Alert Days on WPTV News Channel 5.
You deserve nothing less than the best. You deserve Mercedes-Benz of Delray, where you get the best for less than you'd expect. Like a new 2015 Mercedes-Benz C300 Sports Sedan for $349 a month. Or a new 2015 Mercedes-Benz E350 Sports Sedan, $489 a month. Only at Mercedes-Benz of Delray. Get the best for less than you'd expect. MercedesFLA.com.
Attention Miami Marlins fans. Papa John's is making this season even better with the Miami Marlins Double Play. All season long, enjoy two large two-topping pizzas and a two-liter for only $22. Just go to papajohns.com and enter online promo code MM222 because every great team deserves a great pizza. Get the Miami Marlins Double Play today only from Papa John's, the official pizza of the Miami Marlins.
Better ingredients, better pizza, Papa John's.
We're donating!
Us too!
We brought a backpack!
And you can help, just like my friends here. A child can't go to school without shoes, and many kids in our community don't have the basics they need. Go to WPTV.com and find locations to donate new or gently used sneakers, shoes, and backpacks. Let's make a difference together.
Thanks for helping!
Operation Sneaks for School is sponsored by Festival Flea Market Mall.
Enjoy a wonderful yacht cruise on the picturesque Intercoastal aboard the beautiful Lady Atlantic or Lady Del Rey. Pass stately mansions while enjoying a cool drink or delicious food prepared right on board. This summer, it gets even better with friendly rates. Find us at DelrayYachtCruises.com.
Okay, this is a great story here. It's about an unexpected gift that a Florida waitress got while at work. Here's Newsy's Catherine Beek with the story.
She actually told me she was my guardian angel, like if I ever needed anything.
That was Kari Vanerdoy, a Florida waitress who received a $1,000 tip on a $29 check.
Thought it was $10 at first, because that would have been a nice tip on that tab. But it was really two extra zeros.
Newsy's partners at WFTS report Vanerdoy is a 22-year-old mother who's been attending school and working multiple jobs to save up enough money to find a bigger place to live. She told WFTS she'd never served those patrons before, but Vanerdoy did say she'd once received a $160 tip when her customers inquired about tips she'd gotten in the past. We're seeing more and more of these generous tips. In November, a Colorado waitress was left a $1,000 tip by a woman who wanted to pay it forward after seeing a Facebook post about leaving large tips. Vanerdoy says with the help of that extra money, she can now purchase furniture for her new home. For Newsy, I'm Catherine Beek. Watch Newsy 24/7 on your TV or download the Newsy app for on-the-go updates.
All right, I'm here with anchor Michael Williams right now talking about some stories we're working on for the 5 o'clock hour. What are we looking at?
Talk about the now. Right now, we're helping you keep an eye, as I know you all have been doing, a dynamic weather day, as we tend to see in summer, and we're starting to see more of that buildup of storms. We didn't have some for a while, so Steve Weigel and his team keeping an eye on that.
There they are.
Putting it up on the screen now, but it's worth reminding you, we've got a sharp eye on this every minute, looking at your neighborhoods. We'll continue to do that. Five, we've had some strong lines to move through. I'll leave the expertise to the meteorologist and quit playing around with the weather map, but we're keeping a sharp eye on it.
Okay, Michael, thank you so much. Appreciate it. We'll see you then. Okay, a record sale for a Jupiter Island home coming up next on the Now South Florida. What was included in that $38 million sale? Plus, got on camera, a driver crashes after jumping the drawbridge on the Flagler Bridge. What police are blaming for this crash?
When it's 5 o'clock on News Channel 5, you need to know what's happening right now. Steve Winkle with weather safety and accuracy right when and where you need it. WPTV News Channel 5.
Kogan and DeSavo, they're all wonderful people. They work very hard.
Elaine turned to us to help fight for the care and money her husband deserved.
They never quit. They don't give up.
If you or a loved one has been seriously injured, call Kogan and DeSavo now.
Today, you're in the know with the refinery.
Hi, I'm Cheryl Burke, and today we're in the know with Michaela Vera.
Chief Marketing Officer, and Edward Heath, a patient of the refinery. Welcome.
Thank you.
Now tell us a little bit about the refinery.
The refinery is a total transformation clinic for both men and women. Doctors on staff, we have everything medically supervised to create maximum results for our patients. And today we're focusing on our Zerona laser.
Zerona laser, tell us about that.
The Zerona laser is basically a lipo laser technology that's FDA approved for inch and weight loss. So it's basically a laser that creates tiny little microscopic tears in your fat cells and allows the fat to seep out, creating inch and pound loss.
Wonderful. Now, Edward, tell us about your experience.
It's been life-changing for me. I was overweight, 100 pounds, huge stomach. I got on the therapy. I lost 100 pounds and also 14 inches of my waist. It works. It's amazing.
Now, I understand you have a recipe for success. Can you tell us about your secret?
Yes, we're actually the only clinic in South Florida that offers this combination treatment package. We commonly combine our Zerona laser along with a couple different prescription medications to help enhance and maximize your weight loss results.
Wow, now I understand you have a special offer for our viewers today.
We do. We commonly combine our Zerona lipo laser technology with prescription medications to help enhance and maximize your weight loss results. So whether you want to lose 10 pounds or 100 pounds, our doctors will customize something that's tailored specifically to meet your needs.
Wonderful. Wow, thank you so much. And thank you both for joining us today on In the Know.
Thank you.
To learn more about the refinery and get today's special offer of a 2-week Zerona transformation package for only $749 for the first 10 callers, visit refineryhealth.com or call 561-395-0600.
Sloan's is giving away a free alarm system.
Really?
Call 1-800-ALARM-ME.
Alarm me. Hello, Sloan's. I'm calling about the free alarm system. What do we have to do to get one? A security expert will come out to see just what we'll need. We just need to use their monitoring station.
We need a monitoring station?
That's who calls the police in an emergency. I know it's free, but is it good? It's a Sloan's shield.
Shield your home, the Sloan's shield.
All right, we are keeping a close eye on a severe thunderstorm warning in Palm Beach County right now. A lot happening.
That's for Bill Glade and South Bay and around the lake. But we have big storms firing up along the coastline, too, now. So it's widespread, mainly Palm Beach County. The big storms across the Treasure Coast have come to an end, and now it's just lingering rain. But this is where the warning is, that polygon, that orange polygon, until 5 o'clock. Winds to 60 miles an hour, torrential downpours, very strong winds, and lots of lightning. Hundreds and hundreds of lightning strikes. Look at our counter, approaching 300 at times, just in Palm Beach County alone. The storms are moving east at 20 miles an hour, and yes, they are headed to the coast. Our Doppler radar indicating that there may be some small hail embedded, and definitely 2 to 4 inches of rain per hour as these move toward the coast. We're also seeing lines of rain fire up along the beaches east of US 1 and A1A. Massive storm has developed over Jupiter. It is moving off the coast, but lots of lightning. Juno Beach, the gardens, and more on the way if you live in Palm Beach County. It's improving on the Treasure Coast. Palm Beach County, it's going to be a bumpy ride for the next 2 to 3 hours. We'll keep you up to date right here.
As always, Steve, thanks. The U.S. Supreme Court upholds the use of a controversial drug in lethal injections. The drug is called midazolam. Now, it came under scrutiny after executions in Arizona, Ohio, and Oklahoma took longer than expected and may not have put the inmates into a coma-like sleep as intended. The justices were split on this one, voting 5-4 in favor of allowing continued use of the drug. In a separate dissent, one of the justices said the court needs to debate whether the death penalty itself is constitutional. This is the last day the U.S. Supreme Court is expected to make decisions until the fall. Jay Kashmir in the feed room right now breaking down all the decisions. Jay.
It's been a busy one for the U.S. Supreme Court. The justices made several decisions since last Thursday. The two biggest, as we all know, marriage equality. The justices declaring that same-sex couples can marry in all 50 states. Another big one, health care. In a 6-3 decision, the Supreme Court upholding the Affordable Care Act, ruling in favor of the federal tax credits used to help millions of Americans pay for health insurance. Add to that, new decisions today in a 5-4 split vote. They are upholding how congressional districts are drawn up. Now, the case centered around a challenge in Arizona, but it maintains efforts in 13 states to limit political influence on how voting districts are created by allowing independent commissioners to draw those boundaries. And one final note, the justices have also ruled that people who live in Arizona and Kansas can register to vote without having to provide proof of U.S. citizenship. When the court reconvenes in the fall, it is expected to take up the issue of affirmative action. Ashley, back to you.
Jay, thanks. Today, we are learning more about a plane crash that killed three people in Massachusetts. As you can see here, the plane crashed into a home. Major damage on the upper level there, killing all people on the plane. Luckily, though, the four family members who were inside that home were able to escape. The pilot of the plane radioed into air traffic control before the crash, expressing concern about the engine.
We got a real bad vibration. We're losing engines.
RT6 Delta, very good. The field's just off, say, 11 o'clock in about 8 miles. There's a highway just off your right-hand side as well, off, say, 230 now, and about 2.5 miles north-south of the interstate there.
We have no engines. We're IMC. I need help.
Well, it took fire crews 3 hours to put out that fire. Right now, you are taking a live look at the Florida Turnpike. And if it's a road that you drive on, get ready to pay more at the tolls. Starting on Wednesday, the rates for SunPass users and the toll by plate system will go up by more than 1.5%. The affected roads include the Turnpike, Alligator Alley, and the Sawgrass Expressway in South Florida. The tolls on Alligator Alley will increase by a nickel from $2.85 to $2.90. The hikes don't apply to express lanes on Interstates 95 and 595. I know it's Monday, right? The week just started, but we are already thinking about the weekend around here. Is that so bad? I don't think so, especially because this weekend we are celebrating the 4th of July. Here with the information on travel and spending is the Now's Holly Davis.
Breathe a sigh of some relief for weeks. We've been watching gas prices go up, but they're finally falling after about a total of a 42-cent hike over the past 2 months. Lundberg predicts they've already dropped about 2 cents. Now, demand for gas is growing, but a large supply is keeping those prices from spiraling. The current price of gas is 86 cents less than it was a year ago, so something to keep in mind there. Maybe take those extra pennies and put them here, because the National Retail Federation did a survey and found more than 150 million people are planning to celebrate the 4th at a barbecue, a picnic, or a cookout. And then there are all those sales and stores that are clearing things out, making room for all of the back-to-school stuff. Ashley?
Colony, thanks. The number of vehicles labeled Made in America has now dropped to a new low. That's according to Cars.com, which says only 7 2015 models qualify for the Made in America tag. The 7 vehicles that earned the Made in America label are the Toyota Camry and Sienna, the Honda Odyssey, the Chevrolet Corvette and Traverse, as well as the GMC Acadia and Buick Enclave. Industry experts blame the decline on fewer domestic vehicle parts. One of the most sought-after properties on Jupiter Island has just sold for a record-breaking price of $38 million. The sale now marks the new record high for a home on Jupiter Island and in Jupiter. Look how beautiful that is. The new owner, John Malone, is the Liberty Media chairman, and the home has a glass-encased living room. This is pretty cool. That's built on a turntable so it can rotate at the touch of a button, providing views of the sunrise in the morning and then the sunset at night. It also has a putting green and par-3 golf hole. Still ahead on the Now South Florida, a bear surprise. A couple gets an up close and personal view of this wild animal.
At 328 horsepower, no one packs more power into 30 mpg than Infiniti Q50. Get behind the wheel of your Q50 for just $299 a month, zero down. Power, fun, style. 0-60 in 5.3. 30 miles per gallon, $299 a month, zero down. At Infiniti of the Palm Beaches now.
For a best-in-class experience, Infiniti of the Palm Beaches. Come join the family.
The perfect car calls for the perfect price. And Lexus of Palm Beach has it. During the Lexus Zero Down Summer Celebration, lease a new 2015 Lexus IS250 for only $379 a month. Or lease a new 2015 Lexus GS350 for only $469 a month. Don't miss the Lexus Zero Down Summer Celebration. Hurry to Lexus of Palm Beach. Price perfection. LexusofPalmBeach.com.
There's a big difference between retirement and a secure retirement. Well, you may be standing right in front of the difference between uncertainty and knowing that everything's going to be all right. It's your home. Turning your home's equity into tax-free cash when you need it is a simple way to eliminate your existing monthly mortgage payments, pay off debt, and get you and your family the financial resources you need. It's a loan that your home pays back instead of you making monthly payments, the way you do with a traditional mortgage. If you're 62 or older and own your own home, you may qualify for a government-insured reverse mortgage. Now, we all love our homes. Why not just stay there using a reverse mortgage with AAG? It could be the perfect solution. Call us today to receive a free information pack with no obligation that contains a helpful three-part guide and DVD. You'll receive a guide to reverse mortgages and how they work, including the many consumer safeguards that protect you and your home. Also, our important all-new reverse mortgage retirement planner that explains the many ways a reverse mortgage could provide stability and security for your retirement. We then add a guide filled with information for children and loved ones. It's got what you need to know about reverse mortgages and how they can play a vital role in your retirement plans.
Call 1-800-819-8024 to receive our all-new information pack, all absolutely free with no obligation. Call 1-800-819-8024. That's 1-800-819-8024.
Real retirement security makes all the difference. Find out more about what a reverse mortgage can do for you.
Call 1-800-819-8024 to receive our all-new information pack, all absolutely free with no obligation. Call 1-800-819-8024. That's 1-800-819-8024.
AAG, the best advice for a better life.
All right, this one's for all you Top Gun fans. It's official. A sequel for Top Gun is now in the works. According to the CEO of the movie's production company, the new script will find Tom Cruise's Maverick character hunting down drones. The studio exec also confirmed that Cruise will reprise the role of Maverick in the film, though he seemed unsure of when production would go into motion. Rumors about the sequel began swirling 5 years ago. Pizza is getting easier to eat. Yeah, that's pizza right there. An Italian pizza chain is expanding to the U.S. with its pizza cone. Looks delicious to me. Kono Pizza says it takes just 3 minutes to make a cone-shaped pizza. The ingredients and toppings are piled into the cone, which is made from fresh dough. They sell from between $3 and $5. Kono Pizza is located at the Florida Mall in Orlando. A family with four girls and one boy is expecting another little one, so they did a gender reveal for their kids, like most parents, but not everyone is too happy about it. Our friends at Right This Minute have more.
What's up, The Now? I'm Beth Troutman.
And I'm Ollie Pettigrew. What do you got for me today, Bethels?
I have the most priceless reaction to a gender reveal of a baby. Check this out. You've got a very large family here. Those are siblings, four girls, one boy. The
wow.
Boy, the youngest, 7-year-old Tate.
Ready?
Now that's grandma there about to lift that trash can lid and balloons are about to pop out. And they're pink.
Oh, he looks so disappointed.
I know, look at the poor fella. He's hanging his head. He already has four sisters. He was hoping for a brother and now has one more sister.
I just want to give the little guy a hug. It'll be all right, buddy, I'm sure.
Now he heads over to the garbage can, hoping that some blue balloons might pop right out of there, but no, it's a girl. For all the latest videos, you can catch us on Right This Minute.
Poor guy, priceless face. Okay, coming up on the Now South Florida, unbelievable video here from Palm Beach. A driver jumped that bridge and then crashes. Why police say he did it.
It's early morning. You're up because, well, the work never stops.
The weather team is so important to me because I need accurate, reliable information.
WPTV Storm Team 5, only in one neighborhood that matters, yours.
I have to know what and where the weather is happening.
Showcasing the storm from every angle.
I'm watching and waiting on that radar to find out what my afternoon is going to look like.
Storm Team 5, the only morning weather team. Today on 5 on WPTV News Channel 5.
At Bedner's, freshness sounds like this. And looks like this. I'm Steve Bedner. Visit Bedner's today. Fresh, locally grown produce from our farm to your table.
Kids are expensive, so I'm always looking to get more for my money. That's why I switched from UVerse to Xfinity. They have the most free on-demand TV shows and movies on all my devices. It's perfect for me, because my kids are costing me a fortune.
I'm going to Carlo!
Don't settle for UVerse. Xfinity is perfect for people who want more entertainment for their money. Sign up today or get started with this great offer. Call or go online today.
Hi, I'm Mike Sonsini, one of the owners of Screen Builders. You may have seen news reports about a fraudulent company with a name similar to ours. I'd like to set the record straight. Our company, Screen Builders, has been serving the South Florida community for 28 years. We don't cut corners. So remember, we're the original Screen Builders. We're here to stay, and we'll continue serving you with honesty, integrity, and customer service.
Car accident?
People are talking about Steinger is going green, and here's what they're saying.
Very impressed. An A-plus firm.
I heard that.
Very professional. What a fantastic team.
There's more where that came from.
You guys are the best.
A perfect 10.
I would recommend your firm to anyone.
I am very happy with the outcome.
That's what I'm talking about.
If you've been injured in a car accident, find out why people are talking about Steinger is going green.
800-561-1111.
Enjoy your new shield.
Thanks.
How much did you spend on this?
Nothing. It was free, and they put it in just a day.
Well, if it was free and they put it in that fast, how good could it be?
You tell me.
She's got a Sloman Shield, the ultimate home security system. It's free, and yes, it's real good.
Okay, the system's great, honey. Please disarm it.
At Bedner's, freshness sounds like this. And looks like this. I'm Steve Bedner. Visit Bedner's today. Fresh, locally grown produce from our farm to your table.
Right now, you are looking live from our traffic cam. This is I-95 and PGA Boulevard. The road looks clear, but as you can see in the distance, there are major storm clouds. We're watching that storm system make its way through Palm Beach County. Steve Weigel will be in just a bit to bring you updates on that. A Montana family picked up a dangerous wannabe hitchhiker on their way back from Yellowstone National Park. That guy, a grizzly bear, jumped onto the family's car. The whole experience caught on camera. Asia Gore has the story.
Oh my God, there's a bear on my car. Oh my gosh.
A rare bear encounter. One Montana family sat face to face with a grizzly.
They were just grazing mostly on the grass. They weren't bothering anybody. Then one bear decided to check out one of the cars across the street. And he did, and then he dropped down and beelined right for our vehicle.
David Peters says the experience behind a few inches of glass.
Where'd he go?
He's coming up
oh
the window.
Oh my gosh, I'm so scared. Oh my gosh.
Was really more exciting than scary.
It wasn't really scary for my wife and I. We've had experience with bears before. And the bears didn't show any sign of aggression. They were more curious than anything else.
But what that video doesn't show is Peters was actually outside.
numerous interviews in my career. The case law is replete with prosecutors doing that. So there's nothing inappropriate by this, and that I have no doubt that that motion will be denied.
The defense is trying now to subpoena Mr. Bachdahl as a witness because he was with the detective who questioned Tisdale. The third issue that the judge needs to rule on, whether Tisdale's criminal past can be admitted.
A crash involving a motorhome shut down several lanes of traffic in Martin County today. The crash happening in the northbound lanes near mile marker 102 just south of Stewart. Two lanes were closed because of the crash, the motorhome landing ultimately on its roof. Still trying to get word on injuries. The lanes of traffic are back open tonight. A woman who was rescued this morning after being trapped in a culvert, and we were on scene. The rescue happened just before noon in Lake Mary in Palm Beach Gardens. Exclusive pictures from Chopper 5. Police say the 32-year-old was swimming in the lake. Some people heard her yelling, so they called fire rescue officers who were able to pull her out and get her to a hospital. We're checking on her condition.
Ku Klux Klan symbols are being found in the western Palm Beach County communities. They're spray painted on road signs. This comes just a week after recruitment flyers were found in that same area. News Channel 5's Jamel Lene joins us now with reaction from community leaders in that area. Jamel.
Ashley, they say they believe flyers from the KKK and swastika symbols being spray painted on these street signs is in response to the move by some states and stores to remove the Confederate flag. Officials say whether these recent acts are a joke or the real deal, there is no room for hate in their communities.
Susan Matarazzo didn't expect to see this on her walk by Hall Boulevard and 100th Lane North through the acreage this morning.
I think it's absolutely horrible.
Road signs tagged with graffiti with KKK letters and a swastika.
I don't understand why people need to express themselves in such a hateful manner.
Indian Trail Improvement District leaders ordering road crews to get rid of the signs immediately. Officials believe this may be the action of teens misbehaving.
I think maybe more parent involvement, teaching their kids, you know, of not so much hate.
This comes 1 week after KKK recruitment flyers were found in driveways of residents in western Palm Beach County communities. Another act district leaders do not condone.
I don't support the KKK's efforts passing out flyers in our area.
District Board Supervisor Michelle Damone says the White Knights could be targeting the Western communities because they embrace a Southern lifestyle and looking for members who want to help protect the Confederate flag. But she says the KKK sends the wrong message.
If anyone wants to stand in peace to protect it, I'll stand by them doing that. But I don't want any hatred in our community. I don't want any symbols in our community that stand for hatred. And quite honestly, if anybody wants to stand for Southern pride, they just have to do it with respect.
When we called the number on the flyer, which is a North Carolina phone number, KKK representatives called back to say the flyer is a national recruiting effort. They said so far more than 200 people have reached out to them all over the country expressing interest, but none of them from western Palm Beach County communities. Reporting live in the studio, Jamel Lene, WPTV News Channel 5.
Jay Cashmere live in the feed room right now where the FBI and Homeland Security warning people about possible terror attacks that could happen on the July 4th weekend. The warning didn't mention any specific known plots, but especially urged local law enforcement to be vigilant. Last week, we saw a trio of what appeared to be ISIS-inspired attacks in France, Tunisia, and Kuwait. Homeland Security says any potential attacks could be difficult to predict or disrupt because of the nature of ISIS. Now, security officials say there is no reason at all for you all, the public, not to attend any July 4th events, but they remind everyone, if you see something, say something. Live from the feed room, back to you.
Thank you, Jay. Well, tonight we have learned when funeral services for the St. Lucie County Corrections deputy killed in a car crash last week will be held. Deputy Alan Ross was in his uniform driving into work in his own vehicle when he crashed into a pole on the side of I-95 in Fort Pierce. Ross was a 20-year veteran with the Florida Department of Corrections, and he spent 2 years at the St. Lucie County Sheriff's Office. Visitation will take place tomorrow from 5 to 7 p.m. at Westside Baptist Church in Fort Pierce. Funeral services will be held Wednesday at 1:30, also at Westside Baptist Church.
Following up where they left off last week, more big decisions from the U.S. Supreme Court today. A controversial lethal injection drug, it says, can be used. In a 5-4 vote, justices said the drug in question does not violate a constitutional ban on cruel and unusual punishment. Three death row inmates brought the challenge Six states, including Florida, use the drug as an option for lethal injection executions. Meanwhile, a Texas case challenging affirmative action heads back to the U.S. Supreme Court next term. It will rehear arguments in a case concerning a public university that takes race into consideration as one factor for admissions. It marks the second time the court will hear a challenge on that from Abigail Fisher, who is white, targeting the admissions policy at the University of Texas. And the court ruling against air pollution rules imposed, as we move on to the next story, rules imposed by the Environmental Protection Agency. It said the EPA did not consider the cost on the energy industry before deciding to regulate toxic emissions from plants. Supporters of the rules say public health will be at risk, but 23 states joined in the suit against the federal government. They argued regulations impose expenses on you, the consumer, and threatened to put some electric utilities out of business.
Greece's ongoing financial crisis has led to an emergency banking shutdown for at least 6 days. The crisis is setting off a worldwide chain reaction. The U.S. markets are down big today. You can see here the Dow down 350 points. Overseas markets in Japan and London were down 2% and 3%. After 5 years of cuts on government services, the country still cannot repay its loan of $1.5 billion. Now the long lines at ATMs depleted of cash are not just hitting Greeks. People on vacation are also caught up in this financial crisis.
I'm completely out of euros right now, and I feel like I can't get any more. So I had to have someone pay for my breakfast and everything.
Gas stations have put up signs that they will not accept credit cards. One man said lines were so long, he went to 3 gas stations before finally being able to fill up.
A death spiral. That's how Puerto Rico's governor describes where his economy's heading. Puerto Rico owes about $73 billion on its debt, which the government says it cannot pay. That means the U.S. territory could run out of money as soon as July and possibly lead to a government shutdown. Florida U.S. Senator Bill Nelson is meeting with both SpaceX and NASA to find answers about the explosion that destroyed yet another unmanned rocket. The cargo ship was destroyed shortly after takeoff from Cape Canaveral Sunday en route to the International Space Station. With about 4,000 pounds of supplies, it's the third time in 8 months a cargo ship, an unmanned cargo ship, has been lost. The senator wants to determine the long-term safety of these private missions. Meanwhile, NASA is asking the people who live along the Atlantic coast to be on the lookout for possible rocket debris. They remind people that the debris could be toxic or explosive. To the sports world now, and Miami Heat All-Star Dwayne Wade has decided not to pick up his option with the Miami Heat next year. Wade, scheduled to make $16 million next season, will automatically become a free agent Wednesday. The 33-year-old vet faced a midnight deadline. Whether to opt into the final year, we'll have more on what is next for Wade coming up at 6 o'clock.
When News Channel 5 continues, he's fired NBC, ending its relationship with Donald Trump after his comments on immigrants. What Trump is saying tonight.
He's coming up the window.
Oh my gosh, I'm so scared. Oh my God.
A bear grabs one family's vehicle, or at least tries to. There's a sight right in your window, what they were doing before the close encounter.
Then all new at 5:30, where and when. It will be soon more expensive to drive on some area roadways.
Very strong thunderstorms moving across Palm Beach County. Winds to 55 miles an hour, torrential downpours, and hundreds of lightning strikes. Now working in toward Wellington, Royal Palm and the Acreage, and more along the coastline. How long will it last tonight, and what's in store the rest of the week? Your forecast coming up.
People just forget what it was like to go through storms after about 6 or 7 years. Our job now is to make people remember what the hurricanes were like 10 years ago and not forget that they still have to prepare. The reality is people start to believe that it won't happen again, and it will happen again. We will see a major hurricane hit here where people don't have a place to go after the storm goes through.
Attention, South Florida homeowners. Pending legislation will slash air conditioner utility rebates by up to 60%. So call Lindstrom today and get a new Trane air conditioning system with up to $1,650 in utility and consumer rebates.
Yeah, I love those guys.
Being quiet, that's caring. And that's why Whirlpool made its best Cabrio laundry pairs even quieter. Every day, care. Whirlpool.
Pay no interest for 24 months on selected Whirlpool items at BrandsMart USA.
You get at the end of your rope and you don't have anywhere to go, you can't help yourself. That's what I found through Gordon and Donner, that I wasn't alone and there could be something done. The experience has been wonderful. They really are something else, and they came through for me on the compensation claim. Lo and behold, I still have my place. Life's looking good. I can smile again. I can sleep again.
Gordon and Donner, for the injured.
When what's inside is important to your family, choose the family that moves the Miami Marlins. All My Sons Moving and Storage. We're family-owned and operated with over four generations of moving experience. At All My Sons, you get a guaranteed binded price in writing. So, whether we pack the box, or you do, or if you're moving 1 mile or one state away, let our family move yours. Dial **MOVE to speak with a moving specialist today. All My Sons, the official movers of the Miami Marlins.
Attention homeowners, save up to $1,650 on a new Trane air conditioning system when you call Lindstrom Air Conditioning and Plumbing. Act now. Pending Florida legislation will slash air conditioner utility rebates by up to 60%.
Yeah, I love those guys.
We continue to get in your pictures of the storms moving through the Treasure Coast and Palm Beach County. This picture from downtown Flagler in Okeechobee. Look at those dark clouds. Wow. Well, as storms move through, dime-sized hail is being reported in Juneau Beach at Donald Ross and US 1. Now, if you can safely snap a photo, please share it with us at youreport@wptv.com. Steve will have an update on your forecast in just a couple of minutes.
New tonight, NBC Universal's dumping Donald Trump because of the brewing storm over his recent remarks. The network announcing today it's severing business ties with the now presidential candidate. NBC says the Miss USA pageant, scheduled for July 12th, will no longer air on the network. The network said it came to the decision after the recent derogatory statements, its words, by Trump during an interview in which he criticized Mexico harshly, saying Mexican immigrants are bringing drugs, crime, and rapists to the U.S. Trump talked about the decision by NBC today.
I think as far as ending the relationship, I have to do that because my view on immigration is much different than the people at NBC.
Spanish language network Univision announced last week it would not air the pageant in response to Trump's comments. Trump has said he plans to sue Univision for breach of contract. While in Chicago today, Trump said he may sue NBC too. He previously said he'd give up his role in NBC's The Apprentice anyway in order to run for office. As temperatures rise, so does the risk of heat stroke for our children. Each year, an average of 37 children die after being left in a hot car. We warn about this again and again. A child's body heats up three to five times faster than an adult's. And once the body temperature is at 104 degrees, internal organs begin to shut down. Experts stress children should never be left in a car alone, not even for 1 minute. Speaking of heat, did you know what you eat can help you fight skin cancer? Researchers say that while sunscreen with a high SPF factor is a good start, your diet can play a role in preventing skin cancer. Foods rich in omega-3 fatty acids and green tea have been shown to reduce the growth of tumors. Wearing sun-protective clothing is another great way to block those UV rays, we're told.
Well, doctors say they're concerned about a new social media craze among teenagers called the belly button challenge. The premise is if you can reach behind your back and reach your belly button, you are healthy or fit. But doctors warn that's not the case. Healthy bodies come in every shape and size. They say being able to reach around your body has more to do with your arm length and shoulder flexibility. They're also worried because this kind of social media pressure can lead to eating disorders.
A Montana family picked up a dangerous wannabe hitchhiker on their way back from Yellowstone National Park. A grizzly bear hops right onto the family's car. David Peters said what the video doesn't show, he was outside of the vehicle taking pictures of several bears before one decided to come close. And that's when he ran around the car and jumped back in.
I asked my friend's daughter, Elise, if she thought she was going to have nightmares over this whole thing. And she said, "Are you kidding? This is the best day of my life ever."
Best day because it ended well, but they advise you never should get out of your car. Remember the recent episode with the lion and the park in Africa? Still has the scratch marks, this car, and mud smears from the bear paws. For now, he says his wife won't let him wash the evidence from their close encounter away.
Now, Storm Team 5 with South Florida's most accurate weather forecast.
Storms move quickly from the Treasure Coast into Palm Beach County, and it is near zero visibility along 95 and the Turnpike. If you can stay inside for the next couple of hours, please do, because it's a mess out there. Dangerous lightning, gusty winds to 55 miles an hour, torrential downpours, and even reports of some hail around Juneau Beach about a half an hour ago along Donald Ross and US 1. The radar widespread with rain. Rain on the Treasure Coast now. Palm Beach County dealing with very strong storms that are moving from the lake toward the coast. And our heaviest rain moving into Boynton, Lantana, West Palm, all the way into Del Rey along the Turnpike and Atlantic Avenue. I'm just going to zoom into just about all the neighborhoods here and show you what's going on. If you live in Wellington, Loxahatchee Groves, the Royal Palm and Acreage area, the rain is moving in, lots of lightning, and as I said, some very strong winds possible with these two. Beginning to improve across North County to Cuesta, Jupiter, North Palm, Juneau Beach, down into Riviera Beach, pretty much from Indiantown Road down into 45th Street and a Blue Heron, a big improvement, still some lingering rain, and rainfall rates of about 2 to 4 inches per hour, so localized street flooding is possible, especially here. Look at this storm, just fired up. Almost just because of that heat and humidity, we set a record high today in Vero of 96 degrees and pretty much widespread mid and high 90s. Torrential rains, Lake Clark Shores into Lake Worth, working into Manalapan, Boynton Beach. There's the leading edge right there. And right ahead of that, that's where we're seeing some of the strongest winds too. South County down from Boca through Del Rey, Highland Beach, everything moving east at 20 miles an hour. The stronger storms are now starting to pull off the coast. And just kind of persistent light and moderate rain through the Treasure Coast for the next 2 to 3 hours. It'll taper off quickly as we get into the mid-evening. We need the rainfall. We don't need the lightning and damaging winds. We'll keep the thunderstorms around through about 7 to 7:30, improving after that. Bring an umbrella if you're headed out, though, even through the mid-evening, and cooling off into the high 70s for overnight lows. We will have another round tomorrow. Shouldn't be quite as strong, but showers and storms are on the way as we work into Tuesday afternoon and early evening. Once again, this model wants to fire up some pretty big rains. I don't think they'll be quite as widespread as today, but there's definitely a rain chance. Tropics extremely quiet. Gulf of Mexico and the Caribbean. Look at the Caribbean. Nice to see, even into late June with not even a cloud out there. Seas 1 to 2 for boaters tomorrow. Again tomorrow, the threat is afternoon storms coming off the beaches toward the Gulf Stream. Storms ending tonight in the next couple of hours. Warm and humid, clearing sky after that. 93 tomorrow, sunny and hot to start. Showers and storms again, some could be strong tomorrow afternoon. 7-day forecast looking brighter, less widespread rainfall the rest of the week. And yeah, more showers and storms firing up as we get into Saturday, Sunday, and Monday, closer to the holiday weekend.
All of that as we hear the rumble outside our own studio here.
Indeed.
How about this? An even easier way to eat a pizza. If you thought there couldn't be one, when this creation could be coming to the U.S.
Then all new at 5:30, a look at why that urgent action postcard you may receive in the mail may not be what you think. We'll show you what to watch for.
Closed captioning on WPTV is sponsored by Bethesda Health.
You want to stay inside until the storms pass. This is a very serious weather situation.
It's a miracle no one was hurt or killed.
How much are you spending on a complete pair of no-line bifocals? $250, $400, maybe even $550? Well, how about $99? Two pair no-line bifocals for $99 plus free eye exam. Stanton Optical. Call 1-800-STANTON for nearest location.
Speed Thrills, the summit of speed at Gulfstream Park, July 5th. The pace will be fast and furious as the nation's top jockeys and horses compete in 9 sprint stake races with over $1 million in purses on the line. Triple Crown winning jockey Victor Espinosa will be on hand to ride and autograph a free commemorative Triple Crown poster. Get your limited edition Summit of Speed tank top and your Speed Demon cocktail tumbler. All the action is at Gulfstream Park, Sunday, July 5th, post time, 12:30 p.m.
It's the annual BrandsMart USA huge 4th of July sale. Bright lights, iRock, Bluetooth, DJ speaker. Get this six-piece outdoor dining set for the low price of $129.88. Take home a Vizio 55-inch Smart 4K Ultra HD TV for only $798.88. Or this stainless twin cooling French door refrigerator for just $1499.88. It's the annual BrandsMart USA huge 4th of July sale.
At the Indian River Press Journal, we cover local. With the largest news gathering operation in Indian River County. Stories affecting your life right now. And those shaping your future for tomorrow. The environment. Education. Crime and politics. Indian River County is growing. And so is the Indian River Press Journal. And TC Palm Social and the Press Journal is your guide to fun in and around Indian River County. Things to do, things to see, things to try. At the Press Journal and TCPalm.com, we cover your backyard every day. Where you live, where you work and play. The Press Journal and TC Palm, online and on time.
How much are you spending on a complete pair of no-line bifocals? $250, $400, maybe even $550? Well, how about $99? Two pair no-line bifocals for $99 plus free eye exam. Stanton Optical. Call 1-800-STANTON for nearest location.
Catch your News Channel 5 updates throughout the day on News Radio WJNO.
How could a pizza slice, my favorite food, become even easier to eat? What about in the shape of a cone?
Right, get this. The Italian chain Cono Pizza sells pizza by the cone, and it's looking to expand into the U.S. The ingredients and toppings are piled into the cone, which is made from fresh dough. Cono says it takes just 3 minutes to make a cone-shaped pizza. Cono currently has 3 U.S. locations with plans to open at least 8 more this year.
I'm Jay Cashmere live in the newsroom, coming up all new at 5:30. It apparently wasn't the right kind of bonding activity between mother and child. What a local woman allegedly did with her 11-year-old that landed her in jail. Then, what you can learn from a widow's experience with life insurance and why it may be worth pushing for answers. And will you soon be paying more for your trip around the state? We'll show you who's raising rates, by how much, and when. Those stories and more ahead on News Channel 5 at 5:30.
Business Report on WPTV is sponsored by your local Toyota dealers.
Attention, South Florida homeowners. Pending legislation will slash air conditioner utility rebates by up to 60%. So call Lindstrom today and get a new Trane air conditioning system with up to $1,650 in utility and consumer rebates.
Yeah, I love those guys.
Parents, it's your job to get your kids reading.
If they go through elementary and middle school and they're not competent readers, how are they going to get through high school? Seriously, I mean, it's hopeless for them. The more they read, the better they get at it. It really is that simple. And we got to reinforce it with kids. It's cool. It's a cool thing to read. It is a very uncool thing not to read.
This message from Children's Services Council of Palm Beach County.
Hi, I'm Mike Sonsini, one of the owners of Screen Builders. You may have seen news reports about a fraudulent company with a name similar to ours. I'd like to set the record straight. Our company, Screen Builders, has been serving the South Florida community for 28 years. We don't cut corners. So remember, we're the original Screen Builders. We're here to stay, and we'll continue serving you with honesty, integrity, and customer service.
Save big this 4th of July weekend at one of the top Kia dealers in the nation, Best Smith Kia. Choose from over 1,000 vehicles, all in the red, white, and blue savings zone. Every vehicle in the red zone, discounted up to $5,000. Every vehicle in the white zone, 0% financing available. Every vehicle in the blue zone, no payments for 90 days. Plus, every new Best Smith Kia comes with free tires and batteries for life. Only at Best Smith Kia, saving you the most on the Treasure Coast.
He's gotten closer to becoming an American Ninja Warrior than anyone before him. Tonight, the favorite returns for a shot at redemption. Then on the island, the one thing keeping them alive is water. But keeping it clean leads to disaster.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Oh my God. He could have third-degree burns on his face.
The Monkey Island. New after a new American Ninja Warrior. It's Ultimate Challenge Monday tonight on NBC.
Attention homeowners, save up to $1,650 on a new Trane air conditioning system when you call Lindstrom Air Conditioning and Plumbing. Act now. Pending Florida legislation will slash air conditioner utility rebates by up to 60%.
Yeah, I love those guys.
Right now on News Channel 5.
Right now, a strong line of storms wreaking havoc with rush hour traffic affecting areas from the Treasure Coast south to the southern end of Palm Beach County.
Chief Meteorologist Steve Weigel is tracking it as it moves from one neighborhood to the next. Steve.
Yeah, this is very dangerous weather as it moves through a very populated area, Palm Beach County, from West Palm all the way into Boca. Most of it is now lining up with 95 in the turnpike. It is moving very quickly east at about 20 miles an hour. Hundreds and hundreds of lightning strikes. Just stay inside until these storms pass. You'll notice in the last few minutes, all the reds just expanding and exploding along the coast. This is torrential rain, near zero visibility along our major roadways, headed to the beaches, and more on the way as we get into the next hour or two. You can see the lightning count here just in South County, approaching 150 lightning strikes every few minutes. Here are times of arrival with our storm tracker, Woolbright, Linton, Boca West, through Cypress Creek, Delray Beach, along Atlantic Avenue, Atlantis, and Delray Gardens in the next 10 to 15 minutes. Moving quickly east, 2 to 4 inches of rain with these storms and the areas showing highlighted here. And that is an expansive area all the way from West Palm down into West Boca on the Turnpike and then cutting across 95 across the airport. And this is moving east. Delray getting rain, also Wellington, Royal Palm, and the Acreage picking up a line of showers and storms, not quite as strong, but some very gusty winds. North County beginning to improve. That big storm is now pulled off the coastline from Riviera Beach and all the way up into Jupiter, into Cuesta. We saw some good rain rates there. Also around West Palm, there's the northern edge of this, all the way from pretty much 45th Street and Singer Island. A real core of it over the airport now along Okeechobee Boulevard and Southern, and moving quickly east toward the beaches. A little farther south, you can see the rain expanding, gusty winds, very, very heavy rain. And we do have the rain tapering off slowly across the Treasure Coast. No more storms expected here, beginning to improve. If you're headed out, especially Palm Beach County into the early evening, try to stay inside, but bring an umbrella, drive very carefully through about 8 o'clock tonight, improving after that. Another round tomorrow. We'll give you the timing coming up.
All right, Steve, thank you. Steve just mentioned, despite the fact that it's clearing up on the Treasure Coast, the damage has already been done. This scene from a U reporter in St. Lucie County sharing this picture on our Twitter page, this tree that toppled right onto a car. And further up north on the Treasure Coast, we're getting reports of down power lines at Lingate Drive and Southeast Veterans Memorial Parkway, this in Port St. Lucie. We also are told police have intersections blocked all around that area.
And you are helping us get a good look at some of the other damage the storm is creating. News Channel 5 anchor Michael Williams live in the newsroom with a look. Michael.
Thanks much, Ashley and Jay. The drumbeat and roll of thunder overhead here in downtown West Palm Beach, and you were